Today is also a day about a mutual commitment. Our organization, commitment to Johnny and Patrick, and Johnny and Patrick making a commitment back to our organization. We realize that our strength is being together. You have become two of the symbols of the renaissance of the Chicago Blackhawks.
You guys both are coming off summers where you signed contract extensions to remain members of the Chicago Blackhawks for the foreseeable future. Jonathan, first tell me why that was so important to get that deal done, and also why it was important to do it together and have the press conference together.
Well, I think all that just kind of worked itself out. I mean, it's probably a long time coming. Coming into this deal, obviously the second contract we signed, we've kind of had very similar experiences and contributions to our team along the way, and it's funny because we're both very different people and different players, but we've been lucky enough to be a big part of our team for a long time, and we couldn't ask for a better situation. So we're really happy to know that we're going to be in Chicago for a long time and be around a great group of guys and be a part of an amazing organization.
He says different people, different players. What's the chemistry like with you guys?
I think it's getting better. We're not yelling at each other.
Strangely enough.
We're not yelling at each other as much. I think the key point was when we stopped rooming with each other, we might start liking each other a little bit more. But
we're not on the same line as much either, yeah, so that kind of lowers the stress, I think.
That's,
you know,
true.
we're as good of friends as we've ever been. I'm just kidding.
That translates to success on the ice, too, though. And you guys are mentioned among some of the greatest names: Gretzky, Curry, Lemieux, Yager, Kane, Toews. How does that make you feel?
Slow down.
You have some pretty big names, though, that people associate you guys with, and the dynamic chemistry you have in Chicago. What does that mean to you when you hear that?
I think both of us are pretty fortunate that we've had each other, but we're also fortunate that we've had a lot of good teammates. One of the things about playing with the Blackhawks, you're always going to find yourself in situations to play in big games and, you know, maybe be the guy to step up in those moments. So it's a fun situation to be in. Great city, obviously, great sports town. The fans are really into it these days, and it's a special time. It's a great time to be a Hawk.
You guys are also in a fierce competition off the ice. I understand there's a dance-off going on.
Not anymore. That's it.
No, it's over.
No more. We had an argument. We had an argument this morning about who put who on the spot. I'm saying he made me do it because I'm trying to obviously get rid of the whole Captain Serious thing, and so he throws me under the bus for that one. What else am I to do? And next thing you know, he's doing some. I don't know what's going on behind me, but I know it's weird, so I don't want to turn around. So let's just hope that's the last time that happens.
You know they're going to ask.
Has he gotten
year.
Rid of the Captain Serious stigma, do you think? No?
Probably. Yeah, not. I don't think it's...
Clearly I'm working pretty hard
yeah,
at it, right?
Yeah, you are.
To be honest with you, I think it's more the media now than anyone else. It might have been appropriate maybe his first or second year as captain, but I would say not so much now. No one really even calls him that anymore in our locker room. It's kind of a media thing.
You're both going to be playing once again outside the Bridgestone NHL Winter Classic, but you're going to go to Washington, D.C. and play the Capitals. Why do you think that matchup, Patrick, with the Capitals is going to be so unique?
Well, I think if you look at the teams, you can say the Capitals and Blackhawks are maybe two of the most exciting teams to watch in the NHL. I think there's some star power there, and there's also two teams that don't really see each other much, so you never know what can happen in those kind of games.
Entertaining was the series last year in the playoffs between you guys and the LA Kings, but it was disappointing for you guys, obviously. Jonathan, how long did it take to get over that loss?
We had to beat some really good teams to get there, and there's no promises that you'll get back there the next year. So to come that close, it's tough to just have to hit the reset button and start over from scratch, but you learn what you can from it, and I guess it just wasn't meant to be. We lost a really good team. I think there's a lot of respect and a lot of similarities between those two teams, so hopefully we have a chance to redeem ourselves against them down the road this year.
I think the big thing for us is to get off to a good start. We did that a couple of years ago and just kind of propelled us with momentum going into the playoffs, and, you know, ended up finding a way to win that year. So we'll try to have the same goal we have every year, try to win the division and guarantee ourselves a spot in the playoffs.